Hello, I'm Dan Palmer, co-writer of Fanged Up, and I also appear in Fanged Up as Custody Sergeant Paxton, named after Bill Paxton, God rest his soul. Fanged Up, if you like Stalled, which is mine and Christian James's previous movie, which is zombies and a prison, zombies in a toilet, we're now doing vampires in a prison. So our next film will probably be werewolves in a matchbox, something like that. But it's basically a crazy story about a lovable rogue, played by Daniel O'Reilly, who is sent to Stokesville Prison, and the punishment doesn't really fit the crime. And he's at this weird prison, strange things start happening, and he slowly realises, thanks to Dr. Makepeace, played by Daniel Howard from EastEnders, that the prison isn't just a prison, it's also a larder for the wardens, who are actually vampires. The weird thing was, with mine and Christian James's previous films, Freak Out and Stall, they were like kind of my babies, so an idea of mine. This was actually a pre-written entity that came to me in Christian, written by Dan O'Reilly, the star. And I came in, Dan's not really a horror guy, he'd readily admitted he gets scared, he looks through his own fingers. I think he'd be scared tonight when he watches his own movie. So I'm obviously the vampire guy, so I came in and I added a lot of the vampire lore. I added a sort of a, there weren't many female characters, so I really beefed up this character of Dr. Makepeace, which is Daniel Howard's character. She has her own agenda, she has her own mystery, she has her own quest. So I added that to the piece. And Dan, basically I wrote it on my own and went away and then brought it to Dan, nervous from what he's going to say, because I was kind of taking his baby away. But Dan was over the moon with what I brought to the character. And I kind of subverted what people know about Dan O'Reilly as well. And personally, we're very different people. Like, I'm quite a nerdy kind of guy. He's a very laddie kind of guy. But something really worked, us coming together. And I kind of subverted his persona. He loved that. And, and it really works. Really pops in the film. And adding that kind of character into sort of, like, the typical kind of vampire mythology really, really works. And hopefully the audience will love it. What I would say to the people that are nervous about the kind of dapper last persona is, I'm one of you. And when I was sort of offered the opportunity, that's what kind of like, I was worried. And then I realized that that was a challenge. And when I met Daniel, I realized he's an actor first. It hate me for saying this, but he was an Amdram nerd. He used to sort of like be a real, you know, theater guy. And my challenge was to not make the dapper last film, but to create a character for him to play. And he was really eager to do that, break out of what people know him for. But what I also did, because we're very different personalities, so what I enjoyed doing, what was my biggest challenge for as a screenwriter, was to take what people know or think they know about Dan Reilly or the Dapper Lives character and subvert that, spin it on its head and kind of spoof it. And he was really game. He was game for sort of setting himself up and making himself look like an idiot. And he, you know, people, the audience will see that.